This is the Lancer e-bike. It's full suspension and it has 1,000 watts of power. Okay, let's see what the Lancer can do off-road. Squirrel. Yes, technically that is off-road, but that's not very exciting. Let's try something a little more challenging. No assist needed down the hill. Yeah, the bike can be a little heavy. Well, that doesn't mean it can't handle single track trails anyway. Those are the type of trails that can wear you out. Just going down, not pedaling, but they're a lot of fun. Now, for some of you, that may be a little bit too aggressive for your riding style. But if you're the type that likes off-road single track with some ruts and bumps and rocks and little drops, that's what the Lancer is made for. I grew up mountain biking here in the foothills of the Sierra Nevada mountains in Northern California, and trails just like this are what I learned to mountain bike ride on. These are what I exercised on, these are what I had fun on, and so something like this that can get me down these trails effortlessly with its full suspension design and its fatter tires, but also get me back up the hills when I need to, makes it a really good fit. And this is what you need 1,000 watts for. This is the Lancer e-bike. It's full suspension and it has 1,000 watts of power. And there are probably two questions you've asked yourself if you've looked at a bike like this. Do you need 1,000 watts and do you need full suspension? The short answer is no, nobody really needs either of those things, but we also don't need e-bikes. We don't even need bicycles for that matter. We have feet and we could just walk. But where's the fun in that? I will admit this is one of the heavier bikes that we sell, but hopefully from this riding footage you can get a basic idea of what its capabilities are. And currently the Lancer bike is under $3,000, which I think is pretty hard to beat. There are two different sizes. The medium is what I'm riding here today because it's one of the only Lancers I have left at the shop. I'm about 5'10". Personally, I would prefer the large frame. This does feel a little bit small. I gotta get the saddle up really high. This is actually a little bit lower because we're riding on some more aggressive trails. We're also making some changes to the paint job on the bikes that are coming in to properly pay homage to the B1 Lancer. They are going to be in more of a military gray with the Bolton e-bikes logo down the side. The display is also changing to match the color display found on the Foxbat and the Saber models. And something I haven't talked about a whole lot is the dual battery capability. That is something that's built into the bike, but I'm going to do a separate, more in-depth video on that later. The chainring has been upgraded to something that holds on a little bit better, gives you a slightly better climbing ratio. It also has a 9-speed rear cassette. The fork is the RST guide, which although fairly basic, I found to be very durable. It has a lockout and preload adjustment. The rear shock has a little bit more adjustability. It also has a lockout switch. There's a dial for rebound adjustment right here, and you can adjust the tension on the coil here with this ring. So if you're looking for something that can handle the trails, has a ton of power to go up the hills, and isn't going to completely break the bank, definitely take a close look at the Bolton e-bikes Lancer. We have a rather large shipment of these coming in next month. I did mention that this bike is capable of 1,000 watts. Now, when we ship these bikes out, because they have a throttle and a motor that is capable of that much power, we do limit them to 20 miles an hour. Of course, you can go watch my videos on how to unlock things for off-road use, but if you're using it on the road, we do have it restricted. So this is a class 2 electric bike. If you want to know more about e-bike laws and how all of that works, I have another video that goes into detail on that right here. Check it out on boltonebikes.com.